So our brother here has a message to share with us about Psalm 23.
Hello, everybody. God bless. Brother Jeff, he's going to translate.
Entonces nuestro hermano tiene un mensaje para compartir con nosotros sobre el Salmo 23.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies.
So that's just an encouragement. If we're going through a valley, hang on. And if we're in the peak of that mountaintop, you know, prepare yourself and enjoy. Enjoy that rest. Mm. Right? Enjoy it. But be prepared, because you got to go down the valley eventually. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you so much. God bless.
Amen. God bless us.
Thank you.
And we're going to pray real quick. Your word says, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine.
How you doing, Adolfo?
Good, good.
You cold yet?
Yeah. It was snowing. Did you see that?
It was snowing earlier.
Thank you so much. We have many brothers and sisters. If you would like someone to pray for you, we're here. If you would need a Bible, we've got a Bible. Thank you so much. God bless you. So we're out here preaching the Word of God. You know, we have our food ministry, and we get, I don't know, maybe between 150 and 200 people that come here every week to get food. And the Lord's given us an opportunity to preach the gospel. But as you can see, it's getting a little bit cold out here. And so when we're preaching, not everybody wants to open up their window. So we've purchased a radio transmitter device where we can broadcast a message to a radio station. So basically, whenever it comes in, we're going to go around beforehand and knock on everybody's window and tell them to tune to a certain radio station so we can give them a short message right into their car, tuned to the radio station. Rumor has it that they're gonna turn this parking lot into a Royal Farms. Oh. So there might come a day soon where our parking lot's taken up, but
gotcha.
Basically when we first started, we started with like 25 families.
Yeah.
And they would just come up and drive up down the street, so it was no big deal. But now that we have so many cars, if they sit out on the street, they block the street for the business and everyone gets angry.
Yeah.
So we're able to have them line up like this. Yeah, man, it's been a blessing. Like, you know, I was working with you guys downtown in Haven City, and one day Adolfo, he just said, you know, if you show up at Amazon with the truck, they'll fill it up. I said, no, come on, it's ridiculous. That doesn't work like that. And sure enough, we just rented a U-Haul and showed up, and they filled up the truck, you know, at the beginning of June. And just every week since then, the Lord's been so faithful to us.
I had no idea all this was going on, everyone.
Hey, brother, that's what we were saying. Like, you know, that's why it was good to bring the ladies from over there and everyone else so they can see how the impact that it's just carrying on everywhere else. You know, it's not just in the city.
Yeah.
It's just spread out, you know, throughout.
So absolutely. Good. Do you mind if I ask you some questions? How long have you been volunteering here?
Probably about 3 months.
It's such a large number of people who are showing up.
Yeah, it seems to be more and more each week.
Hello, Francis.